Anyone trying it? Oh, Prabhu's trying it. Excellent. Already done? Or no? Come on. Because I don't have a camera to show you guys what it looks like, but I can try to log on to the email address, email account, and show it to you. Let me try that now. So it's not enough that you actually install it. You have to send out an email to somebody so that I can see it. But okay. So I've got quite a few messages. Don't want to. Okay. Here's a message I get from. My daily rapid share download site, because I download a lot of TV episodes. Okay. Let me send out an email now. So hopefully you guys should see this increment, and there it did. So I just open the last one. So I sent a mail from my Gmail account to my Zensei account, and I mean, this is the format that it comes in. I'm planning to make a backend server that reads the XML message. But this is the way it looks for now. So still nobody brave enough. Okay. It's cool because you can actually remove it afterwards. So that's actually a screenshot in case the demo went horribly wrong. So this is what you would see on a normal BlackBerry. If I didn't have the stealth enabled, you'll see bugs installed there. What I do is I use an API called the code module group, and I set the group's flag to hidden. And then once I do that, it disappears from the applications menu. So once it's disappeared from the applications menu, you cannot, I mean, you don't know it's there for one, and you can't uninstall it because, well, for one, it doesn't show up. There's another way where you go into the modules of your applications and try to remove it from there, but I've marked it as a dependency, so you cannot remove the spyware from using this method either. One way you could do it is to physically connect it to your computer and use the Java loader to remove it. But it makes it very difficult to remove. Okay, so bugs was one. He spies on people. The next tool is Kisses. Now, Kisses loves bugs very much. She loves him so much that if they're on the same phone together, she goes looking for him and finds him. So Kisses is my attempt to develop a spyware revealer of sorts. So bugs or similarly designed software which are designed to hide themselves can be detected from this. In general, it's possible to manually remove the malware or the spyware, but it becomes a bit tedious because you have to go through a lot of modules. I mean, you have to go through a lot of data. You have to look at a lot of stuff. And if you cleverly design the name of the application to look like it's legitimate, you're probably going to miss catching it. So Kisses is a tool that will simplify the searching and the removal of similarly designed spyware. Now, if you have installed bugs, when you download Kisses from here, it detects the presence of bugs and reveals it so that you can uninstall it. So this is a screenshot of what it looks like. Right now it only looks for bugs because I was having some problems with the demo, so it only does this for now. Okay, so I've got, I think, 5 minutes left, so wrapping up. I showed you that the BlackBerry is very secure. It still remains secure. You're never gonna hack it technically. It's really secure. But the problem is with the complexity. I mean, these are two screenshots of the permissions and one of the modules. I mean, for a regular user, this stuff's really complex. Even for a power user, you're gonna have to read through a lot of information or a lot of documents to actually get to a state where you're comfortable with in order to know everything that's going on inside your BlackBerry. The other problem is that the BlackBerry apps are not regulated. For example, lots of people complain about the iPhone regulation process and about the App Store. There are lots of complaints that people's applications are rejected by Apple because on the Apple App Store, when you develop an application, you have to submit it to Apple for them to take a look at. And only then, once they deem it fit, will they publish it on the App Store. So if you were to release spyware, and you send it to Apple, they'll say, hey, you're telling everyone it's a game, but it's doing other things, and they're bound to reject it. Now, this sort of closed system, while it's not good for some aspects, is sort of good for security because you have somebody actually looking at the code. But no such luck with the BlackBerry. With the BlackBerry, all you need is a code signing key, which you pay $20 for, and you can start developing applications and pushing them out to unsuspecting users. So I'll give you a few fundamentals on what to do or what to watch out for when you're out there. Don't install random pieces of software. I guess this goes without saying, even on a PC, but especially on a BlackBerry, don't go looking for software that's very obscure. I mean, if you are faced with the task of installing some software, check it out first. Research it online. Look at reviews. I mean, mail me if you want, and I'll take a look at it. But just be sure what you're installing on your BlackBerry. Just don't go randomly installing it and reading the developer's description and just installing it based on that. Now, the BlackBerry device is very good with productivity. It comes with a set of built-in tools that will help you get your work done. You don't need to bloat it further by installing every little piece of software out there. So, I mean, in addition to consuming memory, you're also opening yourself up to possible spyware. So limit that as well. Learn and set the default application permissions. Now, by default, the BlackBerry device has, it's not very restrictive, but it's not very lax either. It's got a mid-level set of permissions. But the way I did it was I started off with the most restrictive permissions and then worked my way down. So I installed the most restrictive permissions, then installed all my applications, and each application complained, I need to access the internet, I need to access this, that. And then by that time, I realized what my applications were trying to do. So I left it like that with individual permissions set for each application. So you could probably do that as well. I will be posting some links and some blog posts on later on. So you guys can follow that if you like. This is an obvious one as well.